Are you on a Mac? Are you looking for a straightforward, inexpensive way to create learning videos for your online course or flipped classroom? Then say hello to Apple Keynote. Keynote is presentation authoring software that comes bundled for free with new Mac computers. But there are a couple of features under the hood of Keynote that make it a capable video creation tool. Here we are in Keynote. This is version 7.0.5. So this is the main editing interface of Keynote, where you would build your slides with images and text and shapes. I've put together a few slides here to use as content for our demo. So say I want to take this amazing presentation I put together and share it with my audience or my learners as a video. Well, we can do that from right within Keynote. First, we go up to the top menu and select Play. Now, the item we want in this menu is Record Slideshow. We hit that. We're taken to Keynote's Slideshow Recording interface. This is where the video creation magic happens. Well, part of it at least. Let me give you a quick rundown of the interface. This big window on the left shows the current slide in the presentation. The smaller window to the right shows the next slide up. It also indicates how many builds or animations are on that particular slide. This button on the left, labeled Show Navigator, we click that. It allows you to jump back and forth between the slides in your presentation on the fly, if need be. Go back to our first one and we'll just close this. Now, down at the bottom, you can see here, this level indicator. This is the microphone level indicator. That's right, Keynote allows you to record narration with your slideshow. Now, you'll notice there's no controls to set the microphone level. To adjust your microphone level, you need to go to your Mac's system preferences. I'll quickly show you how to do that. First, we'll close out the recording interface by clicking this X. And then we'll go over to the Apple item on the top menu, select that, and then we'll select System Preferences. We'll go over to Sound, and then to the Input tab. Now this shows your microphones that are connected to your computer. So you connect, or rather select, the microphone you're using, and you can select, or adjust rather, the volume down here. So let's close out of the System Preferences and head back to our recording interface on Keynote by hitting Play and Record Slideshow again. Now down here beside the microphone level indicator, we have some controls. We have a rewind button, a play button, and a record button, the big red button. You hit the record button to start recording your slideshow. Let me show you real quick. I'll just record a little bit of my demo presentation. So I'll hit this record button. I'll get this big countdown. And then I will just advance through my slides using the forward arrow key on my keyboard, and I'll narrate as I go. Do you want to take your photography to the next level? Then you need to learn from the pros. And in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 tips from photography pros. Let's get started. Pro tip number 1. Think ahead. Think about what kind of photo you want to create and how you're going to create it. Great images are rarely created on the fly. Some kind of planning goes into them. Our next pro tip number 2, get down. And I don't mean dancing. Shoot at the eye level of your subject to bring us into their world, be it children or your pets, to really give us a sense of their perspective. Makes for a much more engaging image. Okay, I'm going to stop the presentation here, and I'll do that by hitting record again. Keynote has recorded and saved my slideshow recording, including my narration, internally within the Keynote project file. And the recording is represented by this blue timeline down here. Now you can play back your slideshow by hitting the rewind button, then hitting the play button. Let's do that. Let's just play this back. Rewind and play. Then I will just advance through my slides using the forward arrow key on my keyboard, and I'll narrate as I go. Do you want to take your photography to the next level? Then you need to learn from the pros. And in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 tips from photography pros. Let's get started. Okay, well, I'll just pause that. We can see that we do, in fact, have a recording here on the timeline. Now you can scrub through the timeline of your recorded slideshow using this playhead here. And this will scrub through and advance so you can get a sense of what you've recorded. If you'd like to review your recorded slideshow full screen, what you need to do is you close out of the recording interface by hitting the X here. And then we're going to go back up to the top menu to the play item, click that, and select play recorded slideshow. So let's hit that and see what happens. Then I will just advance through my slides using the forward arrow key on my keyboard, and I'll narrate as I go. Do you want to take your photography to the next level? Then you need to learn from the pros. And in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 tips from photography pros. Let's get started. Okay, I'm just gonna hit the escape key to get out of that. So, that was our recorded slideshow with the narration. Now the other option in the play menu, we'll just go back up here and see, is clear recording. Now, you click this if you want to trash your recording and start over. Wait a second, Mike. What if I get near the end of recording a really long slideshow and I make a mistake and I want to fix it? Does that mean I have to re-record the entire slideshow from the beginning? Well, thankfully, no. Keynote gives you the ability to go back to a spot in your recorded slideshow and re-record. Let's hop back into the recording interface and I'll show you what I mean. Let's go back to the recording interface by selecting Record Slideshow. Now, to re-record a section of your presentation, you would grab the playhead and move it back and say, okay, maybe I wanted to change how I presented this slide coming in. Now, you'll notice these little tick marks on the timeline. These little light tick marks indicate the transition between the individual slides. So once you find the point where you want to start re-recording, what you would do is you would hit, let's say we'll go in here, right before here, hit record. Now you'll get this big warning. Are you sure you want to re-record from the current location? The recording from here to the end will be replaced. So everything from this point in the timeline on will be erased and recorded over, just so you know. So if you choose record, you'll get a countdown and Keynote will start recording over your old stuff with the new stuff. We'll cancel out of that. It'd be nice if you could set an out point on the timeline for your re-record, instead of having to blow away the rest of your recording just to fix a specific spot. Well, maybe in the next version. However, what you can do is drag the playhead to the end of your timeline and record on from there, adding to your recording. So if you need to create a long presentation, you don't have to record the entire thing all in one take or one session. You can stop, save your file, and continue recording from where you left off later. But this awesome recording you just created isn't much use if you can't share it with your audience or your learners, right? We need to take this recording and turn it into a video file. To export your slideshow recording as a video, We need to close out of the recording interface by hitting the X up here. Then you'll head over to File, Export to QuickTime. You'll get this Export panel, and you'll want to make sure in this playback area that Slideshow Recording is selected so that we export the recording that you created. Now you'll also notice that we have some settings to take care of. In the format area here, you have a choice of exporting your slideshow as a 720p resolution high definition video file, or you can also select a 1080p resolution HD video file, or you can pick a custom set of settings depending on what your final destination is. We're going to go back and select 720p because that'll work for our purposes. After you select your export settings, you select Next, and then you'll set a location on your machine to export your video file. In this case, I think I'll just put it to the desktop. Then hit Export, and your movie file is created. I love Keynote, but it's not going to replace dedicated video editing or animation software. However, if you're looking for a quick, bare-bones way to create lecture-style videos on a Mac, then Keynote may be all that you need. If you want to create high-quality learning videos with maximum flexibility, then you're going to need a few more tools in your toolbox in addition to Keynote. Now, if you want to know the tools that I suggest, then download my Video Learning Toolkit resource list. You can grab that right now by hitting the link on the screen or the link in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.